even have to like me. But you will respect me. You know why? Because I'm a...
There are some hiccups when you try to do that. So generally, I recommend just using Design Space, using this one application as a starting place at the very least. If you get really, really into designing stuff, you can try to use other apps, but it will work best with Design Space. All right, so this is what Design Space actually looks like. At this point, I'm going to get out of my PowerPoint here and show you the actual application start to finish. So you're seeing exactly what's on my screen right now. I'm going to make it a little bit easier for y'all to see. Try to scale it up a little bit. Probably don't need to go that far, but y'all can see now.
Yeah.
Okay. Excellent. So we're launching Cricut Design Space. This is what it looks like when you're all logged in. As you can see at the top, it says Welcome GSR, it's Greenwell Springs Regional. It'll say your name up there if you're signed into your account. That's right up here. We've got a few different important things on the screen, the first of which being these three lines over here in this top corner. Those open up a menu, and I'll show you here, that you'll use to navigate. I think two most important things here are just Home and Canvas. Home brings you back to the screen, Canvas brings you to the place that you're working and designing. Easy way to navigate. Besides that little menu, we've also got My Projects here, which will take you to everything that you've made before. And we've got New Project here, which starts you off blank. So today, if we go to My Projects, I can show you the designs that we're working with today actually are in here. Anything that we've made before lives in here. But we don't want to work with one of these projects. I'm going to give you a small example of how to work with it. And we're going to cut out a tiny piece of vinyl. We'll just do like a heart or something so I can show you how it works and how to use that weaver, that tool. So this is what the canvas is going to look like. It's a big blank grid. There are numbers along the top and the left. Those are your inch measurements. They are the same as what's on these maps. But you can zoom in and out down here. If you lose something on your map, a lot of the time it just went to one of the sides, it's really easy to zoom out. And you can see those numbers are getting bigger or zoom in and they're going smaller. I already said that backwards just now. I think you know what I mean. So up at the top left, these are all of the ways that you can interact with your canvas. So we've got new, that starts you at blank. We have templates, which will show you basically guidelines for if you are making a design for a t-shirt or an apron or a hat. It'll show you like a general outline of that size. It's not going to print out anywhere or cut out anywhere, but it's just kind of guidelines for you. Below that, we've got projects. That's where you can see things that other people have made. I think Zoe Deschanel is very active with Cricut. She has a lot of projects if you're ever interested, but other creators will sell their designs through the project tab. There are a lot that are there with that Cricut access. That's the subscription that you can use on our computers, but you won't have access to at home unless you have that paid subscription. It's a great place to start if you're a beginner and you're like, I don't want to design anything, but I want to make something. they're already designed, and you pretty much just hit go. And there are step-by-step instructions for the whole project.
You don't know. You just, this is fine.
Oh, it's a good thing.
All right, okay. So we're down to temperature already. So you're going to want to press first to get all those wrinkles out. Just use the right on iron at this point, because it's hot on iron. It also helps to get rid of any moisture that happens to be in the material, too.
Oh, this way?
So you want to pre-press it out.
Yeah, I'll just get the wrinkles off.
Yeah, you don't want any wrinkles. You can also use an iron if you want, but if it's already hot, why not use it?
As you're using it, does the temperature go down?
It stays pretty steady. It'll the light will go off as if it does go down. All right. So now you're going to take the off of your sign. We do have a ruler that kind of just stays every if you want it to be exact. A ruler.
To see where you want to get that exact.
Is it attached to the table or just like
that? It's just a wooden one. It's like that. All right. So you've got your parchment in place. Yep. You can go ahead and press. Make sure you hit,
put that
hit the go button and hold it steady. Yep.
And you just count that.
Count that.
And say it great. And then it says flip it over. Does that mean flip the whole bag over?
Yes.
I couldn't see how you could get it inside the bag. I wasn't sure.
Unless you're
more than one layer, I don't know.
Yeah. All right. So it beeps at you, you can push it to the side. You can toss that part of my paper because it won't need it anymore. Flip the whole thing over. So you don't need anything checked at this point. Just check the bag in place. Remember, we're only doing 15 seconds on the back. So once it hits 15, you'll take it off.
If you left it on too long, it might flip. Start melting it and get a little.
Yeah, we don't want that. Don't do that, is what I'll say. We don't want it to like.
And then you have to wait till it's totally cool.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
So yeah, you can place it down over here. Just let it cool down. All right, you ready?
Yeah,
ready to go.
I'm going with it.
It's gonna happen. Sometimes it doesn't peel all the way off like you want it to.
Okay. It's a little intimidating, but it's very cool.
Oh, man.
When
I go out there to
So you would have to. Is this one you want to do?
I did, but I don't want some of those icons.
Sure. Which icons did you want to take off?
I want this one off.
Okay. You don't want the beads at all, or just the fleur-de-lis?
Mardi Gras beads. Yeah, the fleur-de-lis makes it look like a rosary.
Yeah.
That's what I was thinking.
So.